What are the things we discussed yesterday? We have discussed what do you mean by the term reproduction, what are oviparous animals and viviparous animal. We have seen the parts of an egg. In parts of an egg, there are three parts are there: egg white, yolk and eggshell. And then we have seen about life cycle of chick and frog. And I have given some activity to you. Have you all completed that activity? So during the checking, I will check that one. And now we will discuss about life cycle of a butterfly. Okay. Here also, the butterfly, it undergoes the serious changes. So there are four stages are there. So let us see one by one. See the first point. The young of the butterfly, it is called larva. Okay. What is the first one? The young of the butterfly, it is called larva. It undergoes the metamorphosis to grow into an adult butterfly. So first, what the butterfly will do? The butterfly lays the thousands of eggs, usually on the underside of the leaves. What the butterfly will do? It will lay the thousands of eggs on the underside of leaves. Then each egg, it will develop into the worm like larva. It is called the caterpillar. Okay, from the egg a small worm will be coming. It is called caterpillar. If you see the caterpillar, it does not have the wings. Okay, then it feeds on the leaves on which it is hatched. Okay. Means it will start eating the leaves. When it grows bigger, the old skin is removed from their body. And this process name, it is called the molting process. Okay. And then after reaching the certain size, it stops eating and will go into the case and is called pupa. Okay. So within the pupa, remarkable transformation will be taking place, and then from that pupa, a fully developed butterfly will be coming. This is said to be the life cycle of a butterfly. I'm repeating again. In the life cycle of butterfly, starting up to an adult, it undergoes serious changes. These serious changes, it is called metamorphosis. First, the butterfly will lay the eggs on the leaves. Once the egg mature, it develops into the larva. That larva, it is called caterpillar. The caterpillar does not have the wings and legs. Okay. And then it started eating the leaves. Once it grow bigger, the old skin is removed and the new skin will be coming. The process of shredding the old skin and getting the new skin, it is called molting process. And then when the caterpillar reaches a certain size, it stops eating and it engulfs within the case, and it is called pupa. Within the case, the pupa goes through remarkable transformation, and from the pupa a beautiful butterfly will develop with wings and legs. And then next one, reproduction by giving birth to young ones. Yesterday we discussed about the oviparous animal, and today we will discuss about the viviparous animal. What are viviparous animals? Animals that reproduce by giving the birth to their young ones. They are called viviparous animal. If you see the dog, monkeys and rabbits, they do not reproduce by laying eggs. Instead, they give the birth. The embryo of an animal develops into the young one in an organ called the womb inside the body of the mother. Okay? So once the young ones are born, the mother feeds them with their own milk. Okay, where the animals will develop in the egg, the animals develop inside. Okay, here in the viviparous animals, they develop in the womb. Womb means it's an organ present in the female's body. Once they are born, the mother feeds them with their own milk. If you see this animal, they resemble their parents. Exactly, they look their parents. Then, we are going to see about what do you mean by mammals. Mammals means what? Okay, animals that reproduce by giving birth, feed their young ones with their own milk and have hair on their bodies. They are called as an mammals. So it is a 2-mark question. What is a mammals? Animals that reproduce by giving birth, feed with their own milk and have hair on their bodies. They are called as an mammals. Okay. Mammals also breathe through lungs. How they breathe? They breathe through lungs. Most mammals, they live on land. What are the examples? Dogs, cows, elephants, monkeys and human beings. These are the examples of mammals. And then we are going to see what are the care of the young ones. How the animals, they carrying their young ones. Many animals, they take care of their young ones by protecting from danger and then keeping them warm and feeding them. Right or not? In our home, who take care of us? Namely our parents. So animals also, they are taken care by their parents. How? Let us see. In many birds, if you see the common horse sparrow, what the mother will do? The mother will lay the eggs in a nest. And both parents take turns to sit on them to keep them warm. Okay, many animals, they take care of their young ones by protecting from dangers. If you see the house sparrow, the mother will lay the egg in the nest. And both the father and mother, they sit on them to keep them warm. After the egg hatches, the chick remains in the nest. Okay, what the father and mother will do? They will bring the food for the chicks and keep them safe from predators. Okay. And then wolves. Wolves, if you see the wolves, how they live? They live in groups. It is called packs. Okay, where all the members of the pack, they help in taking care of the pups. Mostly the mother feeds the pup and keeps them safe. While the father, what the father will do? They will hunt and forage for food. Some monkeys, they also live in groups. The mother, they carry the baby wherever they go. Other group of the members, they will take care of their babies. So this is up to your reproduction in animals chapter. So once again, I am repeating what are the things. So once again, we will see the quick recap of this chapter. Okay. So reproduction in animals like this. Animals are like us. Animals also reproduce. Okay. One of the important feature of living things is to produce their own babies. Okay. So namely the animals reproduce by two method. First one by laying the eggs. Second one by giving the birth. Animals that reproduce by laying eggs, they are called oviparous animals. Animals that reproduce by giving birth, they are called viviparous animal. Then, so what the oviparous animals will do? Oviparous animals means animals laying the eggs. Once the animal lay the eggs in the nest, what they will do? They will sit on the eggs to keep the eggs warm. So when the eggs mature, the small baby will be coming out. So the process by breaking the egg and the egg one coming out, it is called hatching process. Then we seen about the parts of egg. The egg contains three parts. First one eggshell, second one egg white, third one yolk. What is an eggshell? The thin hard outer covering. It is called the eggshell. Then egg white, another name it is called albumen. It will supply the proteins to the egg. Okay, and then yolk, the inner part of the egg. It is called yolk. It contains an embryo. It supplies carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals to the egg. So the embryo gets the nutrition from yolk and albumen. So it will undergo the different stages from the embryo to an adult. The egg undergo different stages. It is called life cycle. So in our book, there are three life cycles are there. First one chicken, second one frog, third one butterfly. So first see the chick present in page number 99. First, the hen, it sit on the eggs to keep the eggs warm. When the egg mature, it breaks down. The breaking is called as an hatching. And then slowly the chick develop into the adult hen or rooster. And then next one, life cycle of a frog. Mostly frog lay eggs in water in large clusters called span. Okay. So when the egg hatches, it will develop into the tadpole. The tadpole look entirely different from the frog. It is very tiny, has gills for breathing and tail, and it will live only in water. So when they started growing, the hind limbs, forelegs and lungs will be developing. So day by day when it is growing, the tail will be reducing and at a certain time it will disappear. Now the frog, it will move to the land, breathe with the lungs, and they live in water also. So in this lifetime, it undergoes serious changes. It is called metamorphosis. And then life cycle of a butterfly. The young of the butterfly, it is called larva. Here also the same. The butterfly lay the eggs on the leaf, and from the egg, a small larva-like caterpillar will be coming. It has no wings. It feeds on the leaves. When it grows, the old skin is removed and the new skin will be growing. This process is called molting process. When it reaches a certain size, it enters into the case called pupa. Within the case, the pupa goes through remarkable transformation to become an adult, okay, and then reproduction by giving birth to young ones. Animals such as dog, monkeys and rabbits, they do not reproduce by laying the eggs. Instead, they give birth to their young ones. These animals are called as an viviparous animal. And then mammals, animals that give birth, feed their young ones with their own milk and have hairs on their bodies. They are called mammals. And then care of young ones. Many animals, they take care of their babies. House sparrow, the mother lays the eggs in the nest and both parents, they take care on them. And then wolf, the wolf usually live in groups called packs. When all the members of the pack, they take care of their pups. Some monkeys also live in groups. The mother usually carries the baby when the baby is young. Okay, so this is up to your 9th chapter. Okay, again, if you have anybody doubt, you can ask the doubt in the doubt solving session. Okay, students. And now these are the IBL questions. So I have written the 3 IBL questions. Write it in a fair notebook. First one, what is molting? What is a molting? The process of removing the old skin and getting the new skin. It is called molting. It is present in page number 100. And then second one, what is pupa? When the caterpillar reaches a certain size, it stops eating and it will go inside a case. The case, it is called pupa. Within the case, the pupa undergoes remarkable transformations. It is also present in page number 100. And then third question, what are oviparous and viviparous animals? Animals that lay the eggs are called egg laying or oviparous animal. Okay, example, what is an example? Oviparous ka example, snake and frogs. And then viviparous, animals that reproduce by giving birth to young ones. They are called viviparous animal. Examples, dog, monkeys and rabbits. So these are all the IBL questions. You have to write the IBL questions. So last time, I have given one activity, right? 9th chapter, reproduction in animals. I have given one activity. Paste that activity in your fair notebook and then write day by day IBL questions. So these IBL inquiry based learning will help you to learn the different terms. Okay. And then some of the logical questions are also there. Okay. So we will discuss the logical questions. Write the logical questions now. Why it is important for the egg to keep the warm? Kya question hai, logical question? Why it is important for the egg to keep the warm? If egg are not warm, what happen? The एग विल नॉट हैच, अगर वार्म्थ नहीं है तो जल्दी में व्हाट हैपन, दे विल नॉट रिप्रोड्यूस. सो राइट दिस क्वेश्चंस इन योर फैन नोटबुक, वी विल डिस्कस टुमारो. थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स.